the Senate of the Federal Republic of Nigeria, and Honorable Henry Sen Ike Ekweremadu, Governor of Bayelsa State. He has come in a moment of grief to commiserate with you as a brother, as an ally, and as a colleague. He has come to commiserate with you over the sad exit of your beloved mother.
Is that Mario?
Yeah.
Our big brother from the East, the Deputy Senate President, the Federal Republic of Nigeria. Here you have his Torora community. This is Padia Royal Family, and this is the home of our countryman governor. My people say I should formally welcome you to the house.
Noah.
On behalf of this and your family, I am directed to formally welcome you to the house according to our tradition. On that note, there is one bottle of hot air, two bottles of wine, and cola nut in the plate to formally receive you to this house. Ekwe Fowl!
Senator Professor Ike Ekweremadu.
Your Excellency, my brother, my friend, and my ally, Governor Dixon. Excellency, the wife of the governor, my brother, Senator Ben Bruce, the brother to Governor Dixon, other eminent citizens of this community, ladies and gentlemen, gentlemen of the press. Excellency, I want to thank you sincerely for this honor of receiving me in your village. Of course, you had the option of receiving me in Yanagoa, which is the seat of government, but you're giving me the added opportunity to come and see this very important village. While I was coming, I was full of praises to Almighty God for bringing a man like you to this village. Because I know too that I come from a village as remote as this, and God is the just ways established us so that we are able to establish those communities. I want to thank God on your behalf. Your Excellency, of course I came to condole you over the death of your mother, but before I come to that, let me also send the regards of the President of Ohanaeze, Chief Nyamodo. We are planned to be here together. He arrived at Port Harcourt yesterday. I went to see the family of the late Attorney General of Rivers State. So I agreed to meet this morning and come to this place. Unfortunately, something came up. We had to return back to Abuja. So in a sense, his best wishes and condolences. You stay calm, but I'm here on behalf of myself and on behalf as well. So I'm here on behalf of the entire Igbo people, having been delegated by the Chief President of Ohanaeze to come and express our condolences over the death of your mother. Of course, not just their mother, she's the mother of all. I'm sure you recall too that I was in Houston to visit you and see her while she was in the hospital. And I saw the effort you made to save her life. So today, Mama must be a very proud mother, not only because of the effort you made to save her life and God had his way, but because she saw you through life, saw you as an ordinary police officer. I was able to witness your accomplishments as Attorney General of the state. She saw you and your contributions at the floor of the National Assembly, and she was alive to witness accomplishments as the Governor of Bayelsa State. She saw the troubles and all the harassments and the challenges you had in order to return on you for your second term. And she prayed with you all that period, and God accomplished all her wishes for you. So indeed, she's a very fulfilled woman. She must be a very happy woman wherever she is now. So I join you in saying safe trip to Mama as she returns to her cradle. Of course, just as Job said, it is God that gives is he also that takes, and so we must also praise the God at all times. Yes, Excellency, I believe we have so many things in common. We are both lawyers, and we are very compassionate and passionate about our mothers. But importantly, I think we are patriots. We think well about this country. We believe that this country is big enough for all of us, and that no man or woman should be oppressed. Who wishes justice for everybody, and believe a country such as Nigeria is blessed with human resources that should be able to change our story and our conversation, our narratives. So we made this clear in very many fora, and I believe I share your vision for greater Nigeria. So now that Mama is gone, I think that the best we can do for her is to continue in that vision. Because I'm sure that's one of the things, the attributes you got from her growing up. So the best we can do for her, if all of us to work as Nigerians, to ensure that we create a better environment for our country, a better environment for our citizens, and make Nigerians proud of their leaders. Africa is looking up to all of us to provide leadership for this continent. Nigerians are looking forward to all of us to change their stories. We have enough resources, both human and material, that should be able to make every Nigerian very, very comfortable. Except that has not happened. So because you're not in leadership, I think we still owe Nigerians responsibility to ensure that happens, that their story will be different. They can go home and be able to be safe, and they will be able to be sure of meals every day. And then there will be a good life for all of us. So continue in that stride. You have used the Bayelsa to demonstrate that is possible. So we believe that all of us work with other patriots across the country, including our brother here, Ben Bruce, the uncommon senator, the uncommon sense senator. I'm sure that we can change the narrative of our country. So don't be discouraged by what has happened. Now that Mama is gone, I'm sure that we also find time in order to focus on those vision for which we all share our common attributes. So once more, I send my condolences to you, to your family, to the great people of this village, to the Bayelsa people, and indeed to all concerned their mothers and all Nigerians who feel the pain they are going through today. And our prayer is that God will be able to receive Mama in their bosom, and her soul will rest in peace, and the longevity for which this family is known will remain forever. Nobody will die young in this family. There will be progress in this family.
Amen.
There will be peace in this family.
Amen.
And then all of us will be united for a common goal that will benefit everybody. This is our prayer. I will make these petitions in the name of Jesus Christ, our Lord.
Amen. Amen.
Your Excellency, one of our most respected leaders in our party, one of the foremost legislators our country has produced, His Excellency, the Deputy Senate President of the Senate of the Federal Republic of Nigeria, Senator Professor Ike Ekweremadu, CFR. They used to call him Ike Oha Ndigbo, but we have reviewed that title since, because our country needs the services at much higher levels. So we have since started calling him Ike Oha Nigeria. Your Excellency, my dear wife, Nigeria's only common sense senator, and our common sense senator is not like an uncommon senator. Our senator makes sense, common sense, all the time. Senator Ben Murray Bruce, let me recognize the Chief of Staff, the Deputy Chief of Staff, members of the State Executive Council, former Commissioner, and Party Stalwart Ruben Okoya, who is here, and all top government functionaries. I recognize the Paramount Ruler, my community, His Highness GF Tonaria. in the community who are here, my elder brother and sister in the Sen Ike Ekweremadu family, gentlemen of the press, very distinguished ladies and gentlemen. Anoa?
Yeah.
Amaba Anoa?
Yeah.
Wabi Mutun Anoa?
Yeah.
Your Excellency, my brother, my friend, let me support what my younger brother, the spokesman, said a short while ago when he, on our behalf, warmly received and welcomed you to our community, to our family and my home. And on behalf of my family, on behalf of this community, and indeed on behalf of the government and the good people of our state, I want to thank you for coming, to thank you for your thoughtfulness and your concern in coming all the way, in spite of the very tight and busy schedules that we all have now, in spite of the challenges of protecting our nation's democracy. That a challenge that you have borne admirably, at great cost for a long time. And in spite of all of this, we're able to find time to come. I want to thank you also for the concern, the brotherly concern that you showed and the solidarity you displayed when you and I met in Houston. And I mentioned to you that my mom, of course you knew she was ill because of our several meetings and our engagements and discussions. You got to know why I was not around for some time, and you knew what she was going through. But when you and I met in Houston, and you got to know that she was receiving treatment at MD Anderson, I know the efforts you made to see her, to interact with her, and to personally convey your concerns and sympathy. You insisted severally that you must see her before traveling now, even though your schedule was very tight. And I can't forget that show of concern and solidarity. Thank you very much. Thank you very much. And of course, as you rightly said, the Lord giveth and the Lord taketh. Blessed be his name. None of us here can create life, although some claim they have the capacity to take life that they cannot create. But when these things happen, what we owe ourselves as mortal beings is to encourage and support one another. And that is what has brought you all the way to condole with me and my family and the community, and to also encourage and pray with us as you've done. And for all of this, we're very grateful. I would like to also use this opportunity on behalf of my family, on behalf of this community, on behalf of your people, the government and the good people of this state, to appreciate your several years of meritorious service to our country, for which, of course, we all pray that God will continue to give you and give all of us the strength and the enablement to continue to build this country that we are both passionate about, and in respect of whose future we have a shared common objective to deepen and protect and build a country for all. Build a country for all. Ikeo, Nigeria, I want to assure you that you are home. You are home. In this ancient and historic community, founded by my great grandfather, who came from the other community inside. He was king of this place and of our clan, entire clan, the largest clan in the state, one of the largest clans in the Joland. But all through his life, he interacted so deeply with our closest neighbors, your people. From the Focados there, 1 hour down east from the Focados, you are in Onitsha. The River Niger in this my local government ends at a bifurcation. It stops, and from there you have two major rivers. You have the River Nun, which runs through Yenagoa to the Atlantic Ocean. And you have the River Forcados, this one, that passes through here to the Atlantic Ocean. Our great grandfather and his children and all our leaders, they had close and deep personal and social interactions with the Igbo people. To the extent that our great grandfather who founded here, most of his children, he gave them Igbo names. The one he called Okorie, that's our grandfather. As a princess. After he died, that his son took over as king, called him Okorie. But during the Civil War, he changed the name to Kuroyi. Because they were attacking and killing all our people. The younger one to that, he called Odogu. That is his father. He's the son of Odogu, who himself became king. He called one Dibia, and so on, several of them, our closest people and trading partners, right here. We used to trade from here to my own father, just like several of our fathers were traders. They would go to Onisha, buy wares, and sell in all the communities. My father would stop and sell in all the communities up to Wari. Down these Forcados. You know, so we are the same people. And your people in our state, in our region, are safe. We have a lot of common issues to discuss, common issues that we are working on, and I appreciate the fact that the President General of Ohanaeze Ndigbo himself was coming to condole me and to condole us and our state, extend our sincere appreciation and deepest regards to him and the entire Igbo leadership, and assure them of the very high regard that we hold them in. And I look forward to seeing and interacting with him sometime. But for today, you're welcome, sir. We're grateful that you found time to come, not just visiting in Yenagoa, but to come to pay this condolence visit in my country home, where I was born and raised, where my mother, our mother, lived for over 60 years of her life, and before she passed. Before I end, sir, I would like to inform you of the decision that I and the family have taken. Because she died of cancer, and cancer is a major killer. Just yesterday, I was told by one of our leading politicians, is now, as we speak, is now in a very critical situation. I won't mention his name now, but I will confide it to you later. You may already be aware. He was even a senator. So cancer is killing most of our people in their prime. Our mother managed to cross the biblical three score and ten. He was 72. Still too young to depart. That's my mother. Too young to depart, but there are several others dying at a far younger age. So since our passing, we have become crusaders against cancer. And we want to use this unfortunate incident of our passing as an avenue to continue to do some public good, which she always wanted us to do. So as my foundation, the Henry Sen Ike Ekweremadu Foundation, which I wanted to unveil towards the end of my tenure. And now I've said they have brought it back a little bit. So my foundation, which is now being registered, will invite some friends. Being a good friend, one of our most eminent and respected leaders and allies, I'll write to you very soon from the foundation, soliciting your partnership and collaboration, and for you to use your broad and wide network of friends, which I know you have, within country and outside, see how we can assemble resources, material and otherwise, to build a cancer center here that will stand in her name, but will be affiliated to universities. And we don't want it to be driven by government. We don't want it to govern and support, but we want it to stand on its own so that we protect it from some of the things that government institutions are known for. So we'll need your support. That letter is coming. Having said that, again, I join the spokesman on behalf of my family, on behalf of the community, on behalf of our clan, the Taraki clan, and on behalf of our state, to thank you immensely for the troubles and the pains you have taken to get here, and for the concern, love, and solidarity and friendship that underlines and underscores this condolence visit. So our prayer that God Almighty has brought you safely here will also take you back home safely. And God will continue to strengthen you and strengthen all of us and bless our endeavors for us to continue to work to bring about a Nigeria that we all desire and cherish. Thank you very much. God bless all of us. Thank you.
Okay.
Thank you for being here to honor myself and my brother and friend and my ally who lost a very dear mother. So we thank God for life and the accomplishments both directly and through my children. So what we are seeing today in Bayelsa, you know, is not only products of our own endeavor in life, you know, because she gave us a HSDickson. This has given us a compass, given us a peace, given us a tranquility. We had given a voice to get people of Bayelsa to get to the job. So we indeed they're very happy and thank God for life. So what they have done in Bayelsa is indeed, I don't want to use the word uncommon because the word uncommon is beginning to have a different meaning. So, but I think it's awesome, you know, it's great, and God and the glory to the God in the honor. So, we're very happy that he's here and he's made his mark and still making his mark. We're wishing him more accomplishments while in office and greater responsibilities in years ahead, because he's a young man full of energy, ideas, and a patriot. So we expect that he'll do more, not only for this state, but for the country. On the issue of the INEC regulation regarding the mobile iPhones and smartphones, first of all, that is completely unconstitutional, because we have a regulation that makes for freedom of communication, expression, and all that. So it is that what, even the freedom of the press. So that's the part of it, you know, that they are trying to abridge, which will not happen, you know, because Nigerians are free to express themselves through media and Facebook and speeches. I believe that it's an age of technology. We cannot be going backwards. So we need to take a full advantage of all the accomplishments in the technology, you know, in our lives. So we believe that it is the use of that technology that can help us to relay to everybody on a real-time basis the results of various elections and respective votes. We're amending the Electoral Act to make provision for the announcement of results at the polling booths. So, and if you announce it and people are unable to communicate, then it doesn't make no sense at all. So we're hoping that we're going to accomplish the free fair election by the use of media technology. And I believe that one thing we need to do is to ensure that people will be able to use their smartphones to record results, to record the voting, and be able to send everybody. The international community will be here to monitor our election. The only way they can have records and be able to transmit to their home offices by the use of smartphones and other electronic gadgets. So I believe that INEC would have been misquoted, because what I understood them to be saying is that if you go to vote in the polling in the cubicle, you should not be able to, you should take picture of what, how you voted, so that you don't do that and then take it to go and receive money. So I think that's what they are trying to stop. So if that is there, they will see how to ensure that they are properly understood. But to say that people won't come to the booth with phones and all that, I think it's completely unacceptable. And I should ask INEC to revisit that decision.
Thank you.